Hello friends, welcome to the ASP.NET Core Blazor tutorial. In this tutorial, we will create our first Blazor application and we will understand what is basically a Blazor application works and what is the process to execute a Blazor application. So let's go back, like previously when ASP.NET came in the market, that every dynamic code we have to write on the server side for executing it. So time by time for writing the code, the server is increasing and the CPU also increasing, and it take too much time to load on the browser as well. So for reducing all this problem, some Angular, React, all these client side languages came from the other company, and Microsoft is started with the client side application, because their dynamic data we can write on the TypeScripting language and they run on the browser, so it doesn't take much time. But there is also again a problem with the client side application, like authentication. We cannot write authenticate code on the client side languages because it's a problem for the hacking. People can take those authentication and they can crash our website and they can hack our website. So for reducing all this problem, Blazor came in the market. So how actually Blazor works? So actually Blazor contain two things, like Blazor WebAssembly and Blazor Server. So .NET has written top of the WebAssembly. So basically what is WebAssembly? WebAssembly is used to run the code like C++ on the website. So .NET has written code upon the WebAssembly and it talk with the DOM and it run on the browser. So basically the we write the client side code on the in .NET only and talk with the DOM. And then how the authentication problem solved here? So for that purpose, Microsoft come with the Blazor server also. There we write our authenticated code and then it call to the DOM, means browser, and it call through the single R. So that's why this is more secure like other application. So let's create our first Blazor application and let's see how it works. So go to the Visual Studio Code 2019 and click on the new project, and here you will see a Blazor app. If you are not finding it here, search here and you will find it, and click on the next and give your meaningful name for the Blazor. I will give Blazor app and I will save it under the this folder and create it, and it will show our Blazor server app. Actually here WebAssembly app template is not showing because that is under preview. In coming months or couple of times it will show our in the new version it will show the WebAssembly template. If still you want to install the WebAssembly template, then go to the this URL, and from this URL copy this installation CLI and install through the CMD command. And now let's go here and select this one and create it. It will take a few seconds to create the project. So basically it will create the Blazor server. So it created Blazor app for us. Now before going through the all the files of this app, let's run it and see on the browser. So it will compile and it will show on the browser. So it is asking for the SSL server on my system, but I don't make it enable because I am running in the IIS Express. So it will ask like you can't run this application. So what I will do, I will do the advanced setting and I will run it. It will take few seconds. Now see, it run for us. So it has given template for us, like home, counter, and on the counter you can see like they have given one default button like click me. So when we click on it, it is count, increasing the count, and they have given another template like to fetch data. And when we click on the tabs, we can see it is not loading the pages, because whole data, as I told, it is on the browser only, so it doesn't take the time. So if you go on the F12 and go to the network tab, when you, I'm going to reload this, at this time we can see it is taking hold the data from the browser on itself. So it is loading all data, means all the necessary file, all the data means all the necessary file it is loading from here. And when we click on the tabs, it's not taking much time. So in the coming video, we will create one more tab here and we'll see how this Blazor app works. So that is basically the way to create a Blazor application. So go back to the slide. And so as I explained, like when we create our Blazor application, we need a 2019 Visual Studio. And initially, if we don't able to see the web assembly, and still if you want to install it, you go to the URL and install it through this command. And basically there are two hosting two models, like first is the web assembly hosting model and other Blazor server. So there are some benefits and downside of this Blazor web assembly. Like for this one, .NET server side dependency is not required, means any server connection is also not required, and the workload is now moved from server side to the client side. And for hosting the application, we don't need any host app, we can even host it through CDN or any Azure. And there's some downside, like the download side is larger, so at the first time it take long time, and the app is restricted to the capability of the browser. And there's another thing, like Blazor server, it also has some benefits and the downside, like download side is smaller than the web assembly app, and it is much faster than the web assembly. And this app takes full advantage of the server capabilities, because all the data is on the server now, so it takes the advantage. And Blazor server app work with the browser, they don't support WebAssembly. So there are some disadvantages, like higher latency usually exists because of the round trip of the server, because we in the Blazor server we write the authenticate data, so there is a round trip with the server. And there is no offline support for it as well. And an ASP.NET Core server is required to serve the app. So these are the thing that comes under the Blazor. So in the coming video, we will understand the structure of the Blazor application, and we'll create one tab and we'll see more about the Blazor application. So that is from this tutorial. If you have any question, please let me know. Thank you.